That's the one that we boogered up. That's not so good. Is it burn there? Or? Let's try a different slot. Some more of that stuff. Well, I'm going to try parting it off anyway, and we can take a hot tail file after it. Get it so that they slide in. Let's look at that end later. Yeah, that's why the one flute has chipped away, so it's one flute and it's wobbling.
So that end mill's pretty much garbage. Let me see if I can find another end mill that I'll try.
Take that out.
Go check out and try it. A little buggered to make that mark. All right, now eyeball them again. Straight. I didn't get that too far off. Nope, that'll work. That'll work if I can do it. If I can get them all like that.
That's the one we messed up, the drill walked out on. Before I go through the trouble of parting it off, I'm going to go ahead and
put all the pins in here and see if I can slide them into the master rod the way they should.
Because you should be able to put all the pins in this and then slide it right into the master rod. Oh, jeez. Want to tighten that up there? This is yakking. Oh, I can't. So that the pin can go in far enough. But right now the pin can't go in far enough. So, let's go over to the lathe and see if we can run the part off blade in it. Turn you around here. Get dizzy. Then you can watch me wreck a part off blade. I hope not. Trying to get you in the right spot here. And if I'm standing here, I'm going to be careful of standing off to the side. I haven't moved it since went in there. Point. So rubbing on the side a little bit. She's pretty hot, so let's just let it cool a little bit. Reason I wanted to go with a harder material too is this center will be rubbing up against the snap ring back and forth. Maybe I'm making something out of nothing, but I'm thinking that would wear through. I don't know. Actually, there shouldn't be any pressure on it, but it's cooled down already. just rubbing it on the back side, so I'm hoping that it ain't dishing it out like that. Yeah, she dished in. I don't know how much. Not too bad, though. So if I put it on like that, it should be fine anyway. Let's knock the, if I can. I could go get the Dremel tool and go after it. I got quite a bit of it off. Yeah, last night I didn't get I didn't get my video made. I didn't feel good. Felt like I was disconnected, dizzy. I don't know why. Well, my medicine does that to me, but it was extremely bad last night. I can go over on the belt sander, but I don't want to actually do too much to the edges. Getting there. Okay, let's go over the surface plate and we'll see if I can put all four pins in and get it to slide into the master rod the way it's supposed to. So that'll tell me if it's going to work or not. And what we can do is, before we thought, we can put it down that way. It's actually pretty straight. So, it's not really all that bad. A lot less than I was thinking that it was going to be. All right, let's mosey over to the surface plate. I've got you on a tripod here, and everything's in the way naturally. Oop, get this chair out of the way. I'm not gonna sit down. Now I got you stuck. Come on. I'll have to do some video editing. Take this all out. All right, where are you focused at? We want to look right there. All right, so let's slide these in. Oop. Now the two to go closest go over here. It'll work. Wow. Alright. I just need to deburr it a little more, but I'll worry about that later. Gonna clean up my lathe, clean up the mill, dig out some aluminum for pistons, and is that what I want to work on next? Because I have this, and if I work on the pistons next, then I can put
And then I'll have to work on the rings then, and then I can get those all fitted in. You know, because, like I say, this is going to be kind of a struggle, I'll bet. Putting this in place with, we'll cross that bridge when we get there. I guess I'm going to have to make a fixture to lay it down on so that I can tip it up sideways and lay it down, just like a block of wood or whatever with a hole through for the crankshaft to go through. All right. But anyway, one more part done, other than to burn it a little more. And like I say, I think it'll be just fine with it, even though it's cupped a little bit. I'm thinking it'll be okay. Let's take this out. Be able to tell here if I can get it through that hole. Looks like there's room to put a couple thou shim behind it, and if not, I can turn it around and have the cup down. Maybe I should try that right away. So let's knock them all back out if I can. Need something to push them out. My finger's not small enough to go in there. Push it out. And what I'm going to do is turn them around so that little bit of a dish will go the other way. That'd probably be better anyway. Like that. Now, the two narrow ones. Up here, goes just like that. Turn it around, get the links lined up. Oops. Got one lined up. Ah, that one went in, didn't it? Come on. Now I'm going to push that out. Get back out of there. Oh yeah, I can see where the wall is. So, get this one back in here. Now the dish should be the other way. So I'm looking at getting, you know, just a couple thou or 10 thou would be nice in there behind that. I think it'll be all right that way. After I get that burr off of it. Oh, I need to put a pin in here too. A drive, or a pin hole for a drive pin for the gears. This has to get pressed into there. All right, well, like I say, I'm going to go clean up. I'm going to get that steel clean, vacuumed off the lathe.